If you want to know how to stream webcam images to a client via SignalR using OpenCV, I have good news for you. You found the right video. I'll show you a very simple example of how to do this in just a few minutes. So let's go. Let's start with this empty ASP.NET Core Web API project that I created earlier that uses the minimal API. For this example, I will create a new index.html file, which will be the page that the user will see. So I will add these two lines in the program's S, which will give us this result. In a real project, you probably won't do it this way. I guess you already have an existing page, but for this example, I think it will be good enough. Now let's take care about the SignalR part. First, I create a new class called ImageHub, which is derived from the Hub base class. We can leave it empty for our example. But what is important is to map this hub to this pattern in program.cs file. And of course, we need to call addSignalR to activate it for our project. Next, we need to use SignalR on the client side. So let's go to the index.html file and integrate the SignalR client package into our HTML file. If you're using npm in your project, you can of course install it via npm and import the required modules into your files. Then we will add another script tag and connect to the hub we created earlier. The important part here is to use the URL we just mapped to the hub before. Now we want to handle new images coming from the server, so we need to listen to a specific event. Let's just call it receive new image. And I expect as a parameter the image in form of a base64 string. To display this image somewhere, we create an image tag and access it in the JS code, so now we can easily set the source property with the base64 string we received. Alright, now we are coming to the interesting part. Let's actually grab the images from the webcam and send them to the browser. Since I don't want to create such an image just once, but say every second, it can't be a normal web API method, but something that runs periodically in the background. So we will use a hosted service for this. We will create a new class that implements the iHosted service interface. In the start method, we initialize a timer to run every second and execute a method called doWork, which we'll create in a minute. In the stop method, we simply reset the timer. So the doWork method is where the magic happens. But to get the image from a webcam, we need to install OpenCV Sharp, so we need these two packages. In the constructor of our hosted service, we create an instance of the video capture class. Then we use this object in the doWork method like this. After checking that the capture is working correctly, we read the image from the capture into this image variable. Then we check that the image is not empty, and then we are ready to send the image to the client. To do this, we tweak the constructor a bit. We add a parameter that is automatically injected for us. After initializing a field with this parameter, we can use it in the doWork method to send a message to all clients. It is important that we use the same method name as on the client side. As a parameter, we specify the created image as a byte array. This causes the parameter to be passed to the client as a base64 string, which is exactly what we expect on the client side. We are almost done now, just one more thing, we need to register this hosted service in the program.cs file. And that's it. Let's see how this looks in the browser. We see the image from the webcam and we see that it changes every second. Awesome, wasn't that easy? Of course, this is a very simplistic approach to solve such requirements, but I think it shows pretty well how you can solve something like this. Okay, that's it for this video. Follow my channel if you're interested in more videos about web development, React and .NET. For example, in this video I show a little performance comparison of C# dictionary access methods. Feel free to watch this video next. Thanks for watching. Bye!